Funding for All Things Connecticut is made possible by our founding sponsor, People's United Bank. What know-how can do.
I'm David Bibbey, and I've been given a mission to explore all things Connecticut.
CPTV is sending me all over the Nutmeg State, my new home. My mission today is to explore Hartford. But how? A limo would be nice. My messenger Meg is on her way, and here she is. Hartford by Tandem Bicycle. Now, where do you find one of those?
Excuse me, do you have a bicycle built for two?
We certainly do.
Excellent. Perfect.
Here you go,
Thank
David.
You. Thank you.
Enjoy your ride.
Well, I'm off. Well, here it goes. So on my bike tour of Hartford, I've bumped into these wonderful people. Hello, Sam.
Hi.
And hello, Erica.
Hi.
They're in a band, a pool band, and a great place to start because the band's called West End Blend. Now, tell me something about your band.
We started right here in the West End. On this block, there was about 10 different really great musicians that I knew. Amazing graffiti artists. There was a studio across the street. Dancers, musical theater majors. And I said, you know, why don't we meet up at my place and just start playing some music and, you know, we'll see what happens from there. 2.5 years later, here we are.
And your vocalist?
Yes.
What style of music would you say that you perform?
A lot of us come from the Jackie McLean Institute of Jazz at the Hart School, but of course we all bring our own blend of styles, and that often includes jazz, funk, and R&B, and hip hop, and rock and roll.
Rock and
a little
roll.
Bit of rock and roll.
Yeah. We have vocals, myself on drums, keyboards. We have two guitars, bass, baritone saxophone, tenor saxophone, trumpet and trombone, another percussionist.
And our rapper, who also breakdances.
Amazing breakdancer. We're blending all of our influences into something cohesive. To spotlight how much art and talent is around the West End.
West End Blend. Thank you, Sam.
Thank you.
Thank you, Erica.
Thank you.
And good luck with your future.
Thank you very much.
And now, the voice of Connecticut.
Meet Javier Colon in the spotlight.
Making music that matters has been a dream turned real.
Blue and black, heart torn out. You uncover what's beneath my skin.
To be doing what I'm doing right now, to be able to sing for a living is definitely a dream come true.
But the journey to get there has also inspired millions.
Time after time.
Because Javier Colon is NBC's The Voice. And it's winner in season one.
Time after time.
I just felt very relaxed. And I felt like these people were my friends. And I was just talking to them. And it was a very strange, surreal moment.
And as 13 million watched him become America's voice, earning Hollywood headlines and star power, Colon's backstory, well, it's back here in Connecticut.
Connecticut's always been home, you know, with the exception of a couple years that we were in Massachusetts, where my wife is from. Since I travel so much, everybody's expecting, oh, you're going to move to California, you're going to move to some other places. But it wouldn't make sense, because that would basically take my wife out of the place where she has, you know, the most support. I've got my family, my wife has her family. Connecticut just feels like home. It just feels like where I'm supposed to be.
These days, that charisma and winning smile are effortless. But Colon, who grew up an average kid in Stratford, who happened to like music, wasn't always so quick to take center stage.
I really didn't think that I was anything special, you know, when I was, in seventh and eighth grade. But my teachers You know, they pushed me. They saw some talent there. They saw more talent than I saw. And I trusted them, and I did it, and I would not be here without those teachers.
As his passion for singing grew, the University of Hartford Heart School became the next step and personal challenge.
My years at Hart really made me into the person, into the artist that I've become. I think I grew the most, you know, actually I was in school 5 years. My first year I was music theater major, and then I switched my major to music education. It was classical training that we took, you know, vocal training. They pushed me because, you know, I was so used to not singing that way, that there was rub there. It wasn't necessarily intentional on my part. It's just, I wasn't getting it, you know, at first, but when it clicked, I really moved forward.
Remember how it used to be, it was only you and me. Didn't worry much about anything.
Today, with several successful albums, the popular As Long As We Got Love video, and more recording on the way, Colon's creative approach to both singing and songwriting, well, it always begins from a personal place.
I try to write about stuff that pertains to me. I write a lot about my family and a lot about, you know, things that affect all of us, you know. In writing these songs, it affects me too. And it can be a very emotional experience, a very draining experience sometimes when I'm writing, because I write stuff that's very close to home to me. I've got, you know, hundreds of different little ideas in my phone, you know, that I just kind of put away, you know, from time to time as things come. So then when I get together with people and when I'm sitting down and I'm trying to work on an album, trying to work on songs, I can kind of pull from them and say, oh yeah, I remember that.
When he's not recording, his tours take him coast to coast. But Colon insists he finds balance between life on stage and home life in West Hartford.
You know, I feel a part of the community. We're all over the community. You know, we're always, you know, at this or that, or, you know, there's always things going on that we like to be a part of.
Thank you guys so much for having me this evening. I'm very honored to have been invited to MC this event.
Recently, he teamed with Achieve Hartford and its annual Spelling Bee to raise awareness for its youth programs in the capital city.
It's awesome what they're doing and what Achieve Hartford's goals are for their students and giving them the highest level of education. And this is going to be a great opportunity to see these kids doing some amazing things.
I look back at it and I'm like, yeah, I missed that. I would have liked to have nailed that better.
Colon is also back in a Connecticut classroom. Here at ACES, the Educational Center for the Arts in New Haven, guest professor Colon leads master classes with teen vocal majors.
Because you left me with no love and no love to my name.
Also, enunciate it a little bit more, too. It might help you.
Because you left me with no love and no love to my name.
That's it. That's much better. That's much better. That's great.
I'm still afraid of falling, yeah. Somehow it's taken.
Javier Colon has long been devoted to music and its potential to inspire our dreams. In Connecticut, it remains the pitch-perfect home base for this gifted and grounded artist.
Your touch makes me whole again, and I'll give you all.
I don't need Grammys, you know, I don't need number one singles to be happy. I can take care of my family. I can sit down and write a song in my living room and share that with people around the world. That is a dream come true, and that's all I need. If I never get anything more than that, I'm absolutely fine with that.
Stitch by stitch, put me back together now. Stitch by stitch, put me back together now. Stitch by stitch.
Who better is your city guide than a city's mayor? Mayor Pedro Segarra.
And this is our form of transport. I'm so looking forward to you showing me your city, Mr. Mayor.
This is great. There's no better way than seeing our city.
We're off!
So you love this city, I bet.
I love this city. It has incredible history. It has incredible people. And it's just a great place. And we're sort of like going through a renaissance.
Yeah.
We have some wonderful institutions. To our right is the Wadsworth. In front of us is the Traveler's Tower. And as you go through the city, you're gonna see the old State House. You're gonna just see so much history. We have a lot of different restaurants, a lot of different cultural venues. We have Hartford Stage. They just won 4 Tonys. We have Theater Works. We just have so many amenities in the city.
And now, three Hartford entrepreneurs.
My parents are just diehard Hartfordites. You know, we're born and raised here, third generation products of the Hartford Public School System. So our parents are just the reason why we started this business. We're new, young entrepreneurs coming from a family that just wants to make Hartford better. I'm in business with my sisters, and we decided to name our titles after our birth order. So Addie is the older sister, Callie is the middle sister, and I'm the younger sister. I think that some people would look at us like we're crazy. Going to business with your family is challenging. But in the end, it's just so rewarding, and you get to build something with people that you love, and it's really meaningful to all of us. We produce an array of printed material. We do custom work, so we're making wedding invitations and business cards, personal stationery, and custom artwork. We then produce our own line of cards and products for the retail store. And on top of all of that, we challenge ourselves to make artwork just as artists. We have two locations. We have a studio on Arbor Street, and then we have the retail store here on Pratt Street. On Arbor Street is where our press, our baby, the thing that keeps us running, runs there. So all the production happens in our studio space, as well as the graphic design behind the printing. Everything we do by hand, and it is a labor of love. We make buttons by hand, we fold the cards by hand, we cut the paper by hand, so every little piece has been touched by each and every one of us. I am so happy. I'm so happy to work with my sisters. I'm so happy to be in Hartford. I'm so happy to have this team, and I'm just, I could not be happier.
There's a lot to be said for an English rose, but I concede.
We have one of the best rose gardens in the world, Elizabeth Park Rose Garden. We have Kinney Park, which is just incredibly vast. It's a great place for families and children. So we're trying to do more in our parks. We have movies in the parks. We have concerts and festivals and parades. We have a great symphony, great museums, great restaurants. It's also a very young city, so there's a lot of things for our young people to do. To our left is the old State House. And that's where the Constitution of the United States was drafted in part. We have the Phoenix Insurance Building, beautiful building. And in front of us is the Connecticut River. And we have a great park, it's called Riverfront. And we also have a center there where we hold concerts. It's just an incredibly great city. There's just so much to do here. I came here as a 15-year-old. I was very young, came here by myself. But as soon as I came here, the city embraced me, and I've just felt at home ever since, and I'm just so much in love with it.
When you need some crunch for your lunch, Hartford has it.
Hartford's long been considered the insurance capital of the world, but it has another, less well-known distinction, the tortilla chip capital of New England.
It's coming out of the fryer, and then this is the cooling belt.
Kim Huynh is plant manager at Severance Foods, where they pump out 40,000 pounds of chips a day. Specialty chips sold under 20 different top labels, the kind you find in your favorite natural food store.
We could use a dried hot sauce instead of a liquid hot sauce.
Severance specializes in funky flavors, sriracha, sesame seed, even kale, the latest tastes and trends. Conceived in the minds and mouths of owners John Grickis, Dick Stevens, and Leif Dana. John, Dick, and Leif's dad Rich started the business in the mid-80s. The three amigos, if you will, all worked for food and beverage giant Hubline, which was bought by R.J. Reynolds.
We got the memo that they were going to pick us up out of Hartford and move the whole operation out to Walnut Creek, California.
Rich, Dick, and I worked extensively with the Ortega brand. We're also privy to some marketing information that mentioned that Mexican food, Mexican cuisine, is going to hit the northeastern United States like a tidal wave.
So they used their severance pay to invest in a basic tortilla-making machine, not nearly as high-tech as these.
We started out as a company making corn tortillas and delivering them around the Northeast in our car, knocking on the back doors of restaurants and trying to get them to use our tortillas. We put in our first retail packaging machine 4 years after we started in 1989. The floodgates just opened up.
25 years later, Severance Foods now employs 85 people and runs five 24-hour-a-day shifts.
We're right now looking at facilities in the area to expand.
In addition to the top-shelf brands, Severance sells their own brand, Pan de Oro.
And it's all natural corn. There's no food coloring in these.
This patriotic chip will soon land in all of the military installations along the East Coast.
Red, white, and blue. Oh, great.
Thank you. Although I personally prefer potato chips, but.
Severance Foods takes quality very seriously. The tasting lab, where John's son David tests one case of chips per hour.
I test for moisture, salt content, oil.
How important is the moisture aspect of it?
What's the texture of the chip, really?
All the ingredients, organic, kosher, and now GMO-free.
Trying some new products with fruit in it too. Blueberries are real hot right now with the antioxidants, cranberries.
We only use whole grain oats, pure maple syrup, almonds, cinnamon, vanilla, everything that you would find in your own kitchen.
Ola Foods founder Dina Hauser bases her granola recipe on the one her mom used to make.
I grew up with reading ingredients, everything made by scratch.
Her granola also made by hand in the company's Norwalk kitchen. She first started selling it at Connecticut specialty stores and local farmers markets with the help of her three sons.
Our cranberry orange pecan is a favorite amongst gentlemen.
Now all four flavors featured in half a dozen major grocery chains in the Northeast.
My friend's mom, she's allergic to nuts, so we always give her no-nut vanilla.
I'd say on average now we can do 3,000 to 5,000 pounds in a week. Compare that to about a year ago, we were somewhere in the 1,500 to 2,000 range.
Demands in the granola industry have shifted dramatically in the 5 years since Ola first launched, with a huge push for gluten and GMO-free products. So Dina decided to reformulate the family recipe.
Initially, we used whole wheat flour and wheat bran in our product. So we eliminated those ingredients. We replaced that with an oat bran.
Passing on her mom's legacy to the next generation.
I really like granola because I'm a picky eater, so I can just like scoop a ton into my mouth.
Hey, so here we are?
Here we are.
Excellent.
one of my favorite restaurants, Costa del Sol.
So you know what? That wasn't such a bad ride, was
it? Wasn't bad at all. No. Actually, very good cycling weather.
So what a beautiful place.
It's a great place, and great food, too.
So when did you first discover Costa del Sol?
Oh, about 20 years ago.
Tell me, it's Mr. Mayor? Is that an appropriate title?
Mr. Mayor,
Mr.
Señor Alcalde, Prefeito, Síndaco. We have so many people here of so many different cultures and languages. I get called mayor many different languages. So.
And the role of mayor, the office of mayor, you were telling me, and I find it fascinating, what is that now as an office for the city of Hartford, state capital of Connecticut?
It used to be an honorary position, used to preside over the city council with very little power, not even a vote. Our citizens got together, they changed the charter, so now I'm basically the chief executive officer of the city, so I have a lot more power in terms of directing the departments. But we still have a council that is very powerful. They legislate, they create policy, and they pretty much have a lot of fiscal and financial control over the city.
And your background training and longest time career is as a lawyer?
As a lawyer, but prior to that I was a psychiatric social worker / psychotherapist, yep. Which is great preparation for being in politics.
I imagine it is. Given the mayor does eat here, has eaten here, has had takeout from here, does he have a particular favorite you're aware of?
Oh, paella, without a doubt.
There's nothing like the Spanish paella, sure. With the saffron and the very fresh broth that's put in it to really accentuate and bring out the best flavoring. The special thing about this place, Costa del Sol, is they make paella like no other place. It's just incredible.
Wow, look at this, Nef.
Look at this.
I recognize this.
Rice is a very big component of Puerto Rico as is seafood. We confection it a little bit different, but it's within a good comfort zone.
And it is delicious.
So, Mr. Mayor and Costa del Sol family, thank you, and thank you for watching All Things Connecticut. Salut.
Salut.
Thanks for watching. But let's not stop here, we just got acquainted. Join me online at allthingsct.org and tell me what's special to you in your corner of Connecticut.
Funding for All Things Connecticut is made possible by our founding sponsor, People's United Bank. What know-how can do.